of a Prepper Broadcasting Network.
Hello, everyone out there in radio, internet, internet radio land. I got Chris Plant talking in my other ear. I got to take these headphones off. Okay. Let's see. I got a number of things to talk to you about. Target stock has dropped to a three-year low. And are you getting hit in the face with a bunch of rainbows? Man, oh, days. I think everybody should have pride in who they are. But you don't have to slap people in the face with who you are. You know, if you got to slap people in the face with it, maybe you're a little insecure about who you are. Just saying. And what else is going on? Oh, my gosh. You see Biden fall? Yeah. But what's more impressive is how the news media is covering it. They lambasted Trump for being very cautious about going down a slick ramp with smooth shoes. Biden actually falls flat on his face. I mean, he if you've seen the video, and, you know, then the news media comes out and, oh, he tripped over a sandbag. He couldn't see it. It was black and all this kind of stuff, and just flying all kinds of cover flack to it. Hunter Biden is going to use the Second Amendment to try and get those charges dropped. You know, that he lied on the gun form. He at least two places he lied on the gun form. And now he's going to say, well, I have a right to a weapon. That's the Second Amendment. Well, don't everybody have the same Second Amendment? Well, some people are more equal than others. Let's put it that way. And I fully expect that they will bend the justice system just enough to get Hunter Biden off, just like they bent it just enough to get Trump indicted in New York. It's just crazy. Just crazy what's going on in this country. We have Dane D last night, and we had Toolman Tim. I didn't get to Toolman Tim's. Where does he get those people? How does he get those interviews? Last week's was terrific. Terrific interview. if you have sensitive hearing, though, don't listen to last week's show. Just saying. It was colorful. Yeah. But it was a good show. Great show. Great interview. Tim always does a great job. Hey, and today is Friday. I've been all a day behind, it seemed like, all week because the holiday. Yeah. Yeah, Memorial Day, and then everything's off now. The garbage went a day late. I went downtown to get my senior discount, and it was the wrong day. Yeah, I forgot what day it is. But, you know, Biden forgets what day it is, but I'm not trying to run the country. He is. And in the back channel, we're talking about alligators. Go, man. I'll tell you, I'm up here on the mountain and I can handle bears. I can handle bears. I mean, I know how bears work. I know how they think. No problem. I can't handle alligators. No way. You know, growing up, I watched them Johnny Weissmuller, Tarzan movies, and alligators were always the things that got you. They got the bad guys every time. And it wasn't pretty. So, yeah, gators, I'm not messing with them. Yeah, and this $1 trillion thing, this abomination that they passed, you know, to get us further in debt. Some people think that we're already past the point of no return, that we can never pay this debt back. And as soon as the rest of the world realizes that, it could be a bad day in the United States. But yeah, I mean, what are they thinking? What, you know, I thought there would be maybe some arguments in the Senate, maybe some changes to the bill. Nope. Everybody rolled over. Everybody passed. It's done. We're now deeper in debt than we were yesterday. So not only that, they don't have to worry about the debt ceiling limit. How does this happen? For 2 years? Well, a year and a half. Till after the next president takes over this ticking time bomb. Yeah, it won't be Biden. I don't think Biden can make it that long. They can't prop him up that much. Yeah. And just everything. But here at the Jones Homestead, we are having, wow, we are just, we got the chickens down in the, out of the quail pen and down in the other pen. So, I got to start working on some fencing again. I got to keep the predators out and the chickens in. That's a whole thing into itself. We got about 20 leghorns, and we got six something rock, red rock, or it's something rock. Anyway, they're all egg layers. I got to make a couple boxes, you know, nesting boxes for them, and that'll be fine. Maria is just running everywhere, planting every square inch of soil that's exposed. She plants something in it. And I don't know, it's a crazy time. When you have good weather, when you have good weather up here on the mountain, man, my back hurts. Because we work so darn hard. Yep. So that's what will be, you know, that our answer. Our answer to everything is just prep on, right? What can you do about Hunter Biden? Nothing. What can you do about the debt limit? Nothing. I know the Intrepid Commander says we got to stand up. And I agree, we got to stand up, but where, when, how, at what point, you know? In the back channel, I was talking about how things may de-escalate, and I got a little fired up, you know. I said, this was Memorial Day, too. You know, take back our country. Dang, take back our country. It's sad. It's sad what's going on. The left has infiltrated. I truly think that they are not gonna relinquish power. I truly believe that this next election, they're going to try so much chicanery that it will be blatantly obvious. And I mean, it's blatantly obvious. The last election, there was fraud, massive fraud. Okay. There's no way Joe Biden got more votes than any other candidate that has ever run for president. While campaigning in his basement, his rallies were 12 people, you know, in little squares, if you remember that. They used COVID to the max. And that was the Chinese Communist Party gift to Joe Biden to help him. And I am confident China had a role in it. Everybody wants to blame Russia. I blame China. Confident. Trump was going to hold China responsible for the pandemic, and they didn't want Trump in. So they did everything they could to get him out. And this next one, I think the left is just going to try and take power. I mean, really, they've infiltrated every government agency, everyone. I don't even think there's I still have friends at work in the government, and it's all over the place. You know, the FBI, the CIA, the Department of Homeland Security, every federal agency, to include the military. They put the actual warfighters out, you know, using COVID, not getting a shot. No religious exemption in the entire Marine Corps was granted. Now, how is that? That was a purge of the military. And they put their people in place, you know, their wokeness. But it's our lot in life. We are to live this period of time in this great country. And for what purpose, God only knows. So, PBN family, my message to you is prep on, prep like tomorrow's the day you're going to wake up and find out yesterday was the last day to prep. Sarah Hathaway always likes that saying of mine. Boy, I got a lot of them. I should run a t-shirt factory. Anyway, PBN family, take care. Prep on. And as soon as I hang up, I know I'm going to remember something else that I should have said. Hello. Support our great sponsors. How about that? PBN has some great sponsors. William W. Forgy just signed up for another year. And if you don't have his books, you need to have his books. They are the right size, the right information, written by a doctor. He gives you a checklist to go down through and produce your kits, your medical kits. I know for most preppers, medical is one of those. Sarah Hathaway talked about this on her show. It's just one of those that every prepper that I know of is, you know, challenged by. I mean, if you don't got a doctor in your group, you're probably sucking in medical. So get your William W. Forgy's books. You just go to Amazon, order it. It's, you know, paperback. It's not very expensive, but it's handy. I could show you mine right now. I have the infirmary here. We have a bed that my daughter had when she was little, and it has six drawers underneath, and it's solid wood. So we moved it downstairs, and mattress and all, and that's our infirmary. So that's where we keep all of our medical supplies, our pills, our vitamins, our, you know, our stockpile. And we've decked it out. I do need some more ACE wraps. I found out I hit my knee. But my knees are bad anyways. I got bone rubbing on bone in my knees. And I hit it with the handle of a pick. I was digging a hole to plant a tree, and we got nothing but rock up here on the mountain. And I hit that rock, and the handle of the pick slammed into the side of my knee. Man, I went down like a ton of bricks. That hurt so bad I had to go pee. And that's the truth. That is the truth. And now my left knee is swole up like a grapefruit. I might have to go see the doc. It hurts. Well, anyway, I wrapped it. First few days, it was good because, you know, you put the ice on it. And Maria gave me if you listened to last week's, it was 1 week ago today. We secured a bunch of protein. We tightened up four families. with a quarter of a cow each. And of course, the things that Marie and I got out of it for making the deal is, you know, soup bones, oxtail, tongue. We got a massive heart. We make our own dog food. And of course, the soup bones are going to be for soup. But some of the bones, he cut up all the bones, even the rib bones, which didn't have much meat on them. Anyway, that's where we were last week. If you listen to that, I put a remedy on my knee, and it took the pain away, but it also removed the first layer of skin. So I stopped using that remedy. I think I'm going to have to go back to it because, man, is it hurting. Okay, PBN family, I rambled on for 16 minutes saying much ado about nothing. Take care and prep on!